Do you ever find yourself struggling with snacking? Maybe your meals are on point, but when it comes to the snacks, not so much. Well, I'm going to be giving you some tips on how to change that and how to get your snacking under control. So strap in, get ready for episode 247. Let's go.
The future of fitness.
How do you gain muscle mass?
Fitness is not complicated. It's simple when you break it down.
There's so much information out there.
No fads, no diets, just plain simple habits.
You're listening to the Bones to Bulk podcast.
Hey, welcome to this episode. My name is Brian Parody, and I will be your host today. And if this is your first time tuning in, welcome to the show. So glad to have you here. For my first time listeners, it's just, you know, I try to really break things down into simple terms. I hate all the confusion out there, and my whole goal is to bring simplicity back to fitness. For my return listeners, thank you for coming back. It means the world to me. You continue to tune into this podcast. I know there's a lot of other great resources out there, and the fact that you're tuning into this means the world to me. So thank you. If you've not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/bones2bulk. Check out the channel. Make sure you subscribe. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you think about the videos. I'd appreciate it. All right, with that being said, let's dive in. So when it comes to snacking, you know, the first thing I always say to recognize is, when do you tend to snack? Most people have a specific time. Sometimes it can be morning, sometimes it can be afternoon, sometimes it can be evening. Evening is the big one, I feel like, that trips up a lot of people. You know, as the day goes on, our willpower goes down. You know, we can start the day off strong, and then we go through the day, we have work and kids and life, and we just get drained, right? A lot of things can wear us down. And so by the end of the day, we just want to kick back. We want to splurge on whatever our go-to snack is, whether you're a salty person or a sweets person, like whatever it is, you probably have that go-to thing that you struggle with when it comes to snacks. So first off, I want to let you know that it's not all your fault. That's right. Now, I'm not trying to make you have a scapegoat out of this, but my point is, snack companies, food companies in general, they design crap to be super addicting. Like, there is so much research that goes into designing products. Did you know that Cheetos, it's literally impossible for you to get full from them? You know why? Because they chemically design it so that the receptors in your brain, the food is not hitting those to say, hey, you're full, stop eating. Like, they chemically engineered it so that those receptors in the brain never get hit. And so your stomach, your brain, it never thinks you're full. So you can, that's why you can just sit there and eat them one after another. So there's a lot of things at work against you. So don't feel like this is your fault and that you're alone and struggling with this. This is a huge issue. Now, the second thing, once you recognize what time of day is your weak point, then you need to have a plan in place. And what I mean by that is, you've got to have something as an alternative. You can't just expect to, you know, I'm just not going to have a snack, I'm going to resist. You've got to have something you need to go to. And I don't recommend that you just get rid of everything all at once, because that can be really hard. So let's say, you know, snacking at night is your weak point. Okay, so you already know that. So A, I would say don't have the unhealthy snack that you typically go to on hand. That's first off, just get rid of it. Don't have it in the house. The second thing is, have healthy alternatives. If you get like the munchies, like you just want something crunchy or you like salty things, then some great alternatives is Smart Pop popcorn. They come in small little bags. Orville Redenbach makes them. Usually there's a store brand as well, but they're a small bag. They're like 100 calories per bag, and it's going to be something you can eat and not feel guilty about, and it'll satisfy that salty crunch craving. Another thing that I love to do is cut up carrots, cut up cucumbers, cut up bell peppers, whatever your vegetable choice is, and dip it in salsa or hummus. There's so many different amazing hummuses out there, like chipotle flavored or garlic flavored or roasted red pepper, like whatever your forte is, they have it. And it's pretty low in calories, has a little bit of protein in it. It's good for you, and then you can eat that with the veggies. Hummus, you do want to measure out how much, because it does have calories in it, obviously. But another even lower calorie option is veggies and salsa. Again, it tastes great, and there's hardly any calories in either, so you can really, really pig out on that without any guilt. All right, another thing that I really love to do, and this is more for if you have a sweet tooth, so some options for you are, grab those Greek yogurt cups, just the plain vanilla ones, nothing with all that fruit on the bottom, which is really just syrup on the bottom, but a low sugar Greek yogurt, non-fat, vanilla or plain. They're usually around 100 calories per little cup. And then mix about a half a scoop of protein into that, you know, depending on what flavor you like. I love mixing birthday cake flavor in with my yogurt, and it literally tastes like I'm eating pudding. You got to mix it really well, and it's, again, it's literally like I'm eating pudding. Another option, you can make some homemade, I'm not going to call it ice cream because it doesn't taste exactly like ice cream, but it'll kind of satisfy that. You can get some almond milk or low-fat milk, add a scoop of protein in it and some ice, maybe a couple drops of vanilla extract, and blend it in the blender. And then Walden Farms makes a zero-calorie chocolate syrup, and you can drizzle some of that on top. So it feels like you're eating ice cream, but you're really just pretty much eating some milk and protein powder. How cool is that? So those are some options you can do for snacking. Now, another pretty good option. I don't recommend this every night, but a couple nights a week, Halo Top ice cream. Again, a lot of stores have a, you know, a store brand rather than the Halo Top, but the Halo Top ice cream is pretty dang good. It's really low calories. It's about 150 calories per cup. So you can splurge on that. Again, grab that Walden Farm zero calorie chocolate syrup. They also make a caramel one, drizzle that on top, and you're having ice cream at 150 calories. Like, you can't beat that. So these are some options to do. And then once a week, I do suggest splurging a little bit. You know, have something you enjoy. Don't go insane. Like, don't eat an entire bag of Oreos because, my God, that's a lot of calories. But, you know, if you want to have a piece of cake or you want to have some regular ice cream, like, go for it. You know, just be mindful of the serving size. Again, don't go crazy, but enjoy what you're eating. And what you'll find is as you move away from these snacks and start eating less of them, like, once you have something really sweet, it's going to taste like way sweeter than it used to because you're getting used to eating differently. You're getting used to eating different snacks. Now, if you're on the go a lot and heading to work, you got to plan your snacks ahead of time. You've got to, you know, get them in baggies, get them in little containers, whether you're doing the veggies and dip, have them cut up, whether you're doing the yogurt and protein, you know, you can just take a Ziploc with some protein and grab the cup of yogurt and then mix it later. If you're doing popcorn, you know, most workplaces have microwaves. Just take those little bags with you, pop them at the workplace. You've got to prepare for success because if you don't take anything with you, again, you're going to end up going to the vending machine. You're going to end up going to the cafeteria. You're going to end up going to the convenience store and grabbing a bunch of crap. So plan ahead, you know, buy your snacks in bulk for the week. So, you know, if you're having an afternoon snack and an evening snack, then when you go grocery shopping, make sure you grab one for each day or enough for each day, whatever you're having. You got to plan, like, thinking ahead and putting just a little bit of plan into this makes it all work. Like, planning is key to your success. There's a lot of things that are key to your success, but planning and consistency are probably the biggest two things. Consistency being number one for sure. So I hope this helps. I hope it gives you some ideas for how to change up your snack habits, maybe some healthy ideas to try. Again, I know snacking can be a really big trip up for a lot of people. Like, you can be on point with your meals, but when it comes to snacking, it's just, it's really bad. A couple other real quick things. Grapes and fruit are a great thing. Obviously, fruit is a little bit higher in calorie, so you don't want to just gorge on tons and tons of fruit. But, you know, packing a banana or an apple and having that as a snack is also a really, really great option. So, again, I hope this gives you some really good ideas for things to try and get that snacking under control. All right, if you found this helpful, I would ask you to do one thing. Head on over to iTunes. Even if you don't listen to the podcast on iTunes, just head on over there and leave me a review on this podcast. You know, an honest review, whether you like it, whether you hate it, tell me what your thoughts on it so I can make it better. And also that helps us move up in the rankings in the podcast world so that we can help spread this message to more people. So again, it would mean the world to me if you just headed on over to iTunes, wrote a review, an honest review for the podcast. That would just be, I'd be truly grateful for that. I would appreciate that. With that being said, remember, no matter what hurdles you're trying to jump over, what snack munchy monsters lie in your way, you can overcome them. You can get that snacking under control. You've got this.